Thank you very much for arranging this breakfast meeting with the economic leaders of Queensland. I'm honored and very encouraged by this large turnout. Congratulations to Queensland and Brisbane for hosting such a wonderful G20. For the past few days, we have shown what a world-class city you are. Queensland's economy has been performing well on basis of your traditional strengths in areas like tourism, resources, and agriculture, but also through your investment in areas of advanced technologies and services. This is a tribute to your leadership and to the government and the business in Queensland. I'm delighted to be here for a number of reasons. One, I have always placed great emphasis on relations between states, not just between national capitals. Premier Newman, you and your government are doing a lot to pursue economic opportunities with India. We have sent a number of our trade missions to India. Just this September, there was a Queensland-Gujarat Energy Roundtable in Gandhinagar, the capital of Gujarat. And I'm naturally pleased that Queensland will be participating in Vibrant Gujarat in January 2015 to showcase your infrastructure capabilities. I know that you are not partial to Gujarat, but you are sending delegations to Kolkata and to Delhi and everywhere. The second reason is that today, India is fourth largest export destination. For us, Queensland is emerging as a major investment destination. We welcome the efforts you have made to make it possible for an Australian dollar 16 billion investment to take place in coal mining. It will set a new standard for India-Australia cooperation and demonstrate how Australia and Queensland can be a vital partner in meeting India's requirement for energy and other vital sources. Queensland can be an important partner in India's development in energy, mineral resources, agriculture, and food security, education, and advanced technology in some areas. We have launched a major set of reforms to boost economic growth and improve the quality of life of our people. We have set an ambitious agenda and a brisk pace in the area of policy. We have eased foreign direct investment laws in key areas like railways, defense, and insurance. We have set up a commission to reform railways, which had always been seen as just another government department. This has never been done before. We have introduced labor reforms. We have made big changes in our policies on fuel, coal, natural gas, diesel. In the area of process, changing the way we work as government, good governance is the starting point of a change. It is as important to business as it is to ordinary citizens. Eliminating unnecessary laws and regulations, making process easier and shorter, ensuring that our government is more transparent, focus on ease of doing business. We are partnering with the state governments and even going to district and villages. Digital India, the campaign facilitation cells have been set up. In terms of institutions, set up a new department for skill development, set up a special authority for industrial corridors, e-business portal for integrated application process 24/7, closely monitoring implementation of decisions, set up an expenditure reform commission. In terms of initiatives, we have launched Make in India as a new mission to promote manufacturing in India. Creating world-class infrastructure, our aim is to 100 smart cities, metro projects for 50 cities, modern waste management system for 500 cities, affordable healthcare within everyone's reach, sanitation for all by 2090, a roof over every head up by 2022, electricity in every household, clean energy with special focus on solar energy, energy efficiency, water conservation, clean Ganga program, which is also a major urban renewal and environment protection program. I see great opportunities for our cooperation. Let me highlight some of them. Coal is already a major item of exports to India, but I see vast potential in resources in general as Indian industrial sector gathers momentum and grows. We would also commence import of liquefied natural gas, LNG, from Queensland. You are leaders in many areas of mining and mining technologies, services and equipment, mining consultancy, mine safety, coal washers and mine management. I invite you to participate in India. We have made our policies transparent and predictable. We have made our procedure clearly defined and smooth. Queensland can also be a partner in strengthening India's food security. We already import a fairly significant amount of fruits and vegetables and some quantities of fertilizer. What we need is an integrated partnership, joint research to improve yield and farm productivity, to development of our agriculture supply, infrastructure and food processing. This is an area of great priority for my government. Infrastructure, where we aim to invest over $1 trillion over the next 5 years. Queensland's strength In advanced areas of technology also offer enormous opportunities for collaboration, such as biotechnology and your growing strength in aviation sector. We can develop strong synergies in the area of information and communication technology and at its every growing application in all areas of life and business. I hope Indian IT companies will enjoy good access. Conversely, Digital India offers enormous opportunities. Queensland can take justifiable pride in its success in the tourism sector. Indian investors would be willing to partner with you. As more and more Indians are drawn to the incredible beauty and hospitality of your state. You can participate in India's ambitious plans for smart, sustainable, habitable cities to cater to its growing urban population. It is expected that nearly 11% of the world's urban population, it will be a surprise for you, 11% of the world's urban population in 2025 will be in India. You can make India a manufacturing hub for India, for exports, and for import back to Australia. Let us foster closer cooperation in skill development and education and research and development. Your universities and research institutions have already contributed significantly to the growing science and technology relationship between India and Australia. This is particularly true of the collaboration between the two countries under the Australia-India Strategic Research Fund. I know that most of you are aware of the opportunities in India and have looked at the market. You will begin to find a difference in India. There will be no longer have to reach those opportunities to uncertain and unpredictable pathways, crossing hurdles along the way. You will not only be able to convert opportunities into partnership, you will do it in an environment that is welcoming and easy to do business. Let me conclude by saying India-Australia relationship is comprehensive, involving economic cooperation, a growing security and strategic partnership, and increasing cooperation in international forums, which are vital for peace, stability, and prosperity in our region. I am keen to hear your views. I'll make sure our team here follows up on them. I thank you all for coming here this morning and wish you a very productive day ahead. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.